The upcoming Rock and Roll Providence Half Marathon will support several charities, and one of them is called Dravet Syndrome. It's a rare form of epilepsy that begins at infancy, and I recently met up with one 8-year-old boy who, along with his family, lives with it every day. But with love and support of his family, he lives each day as their hero. To see 8-year-old Alex play with his brother and sister, you would never believe the challenges he faces.
He's the happiest, sweetest boy you ever want to meet. He's very rarely is he sad. Doesn't matter if he just had a seizure or if he's having a great day. He's always got a smile for everybody, and he wants to be everybody's friend.
When Alex was born, only about 1,000 babies had been diagnosed with what is called Dravet syndrome.
Dravet syndrome is a catastrophic form of epilepsy that is a genetic mutation in the sodium channel of the brain, and it causes all kinds of different seizures with multiple kinds of triggers.
Alex has Treasure, his service dog. He is always by his side.
You know, while we are sleeping, you know, there's eyes or ears, you know, on Alex. So that's why.
And there's seizures you don't even see.
Right.
Subclinical ones that you don't even see that we wouldn't know about, and he can smell them before we.
Really?
The pheromones. Yeah, he picks up on the pheromones. He'll bark, he'll claw. Beth is a very light sleeper, so when that situation has happened, where he's had a seizure in his sleep, he's made us aware.
Mm-hmm.
Every time.
So tell me how the birthday was.
Good.
What kind of cake did you have?
Parmesan.
Chocolate or vanilla?
Chocolate and vanilla.
And who made the cake?
Mom.
Was it good?
Yeah.
You better say that because she's standing right over my shoulder.
Yeah.
It's a true family effort to make sure Alex is safe.
Even Billy and Angela, who are playing with Alex right now, you know, it's a family. We deal with it as a family. And when Alex has a seizure, they snap into action.
I hear somebody got a birthday card from a girlfriend. What's the girlfriend's name?
Angelina.
Look, Angelina.
Wait, not just Angelina. Kisses and hugs, too. Are we embarrassing
she
you?
She did draw
Treasure.
Every day brings on something new.
We juggle with our hands, our feet, and our head. No,
it's one day at a time.
Yeah, it's one day at a time. It's 1 hour at a time. It's we don't know what we're going to get from day to day. You know. But, as Beth said earlier, Alex is always smiling. He's always happy. He truly, you know, you hear this and it's cliche, but he's truly our inspiration. He, mm-hmm. you know, and I say this over and over to friends, oh, how do you do it? And I said, well, we have great faith. But on top of that, what gives us the right to be down when you look at Alex and he's smiling?
Happy. With the help of the Rock and Roll Half Marathon, they're raising awareness and money to fight this.
Thrilled. Yeah, thrilled because we could use all the support we can get. It's rare. I mean, we go to the hospital and they ask, you know, what his disorder is. We'll say Dravet. How do you spell that?
I think I know the answer to this, but what's the one thing that holds the whole place together? And
love.
And gets you through your day?
Love.
Yep, love.
And faith.
Yep, each other. Mm. That's what we get through.
Love, faith, and hope.
Yeah.
Right?
And here this morning to tell us more is Lori O'Driscoll, president of the Dravet Syndrome Foundation, and her daughter, Kira. How are you?
Good.
It's good to have you here today. You got the dress on today, and you knew you were going to be on TV, right?
Yep.
Okay, good. All right, first, give us a little information. We saw their story, but tell us about Dravet itself, because a lot of people, as they were saying, they will go to the hospital, and they really don't know anything about it a lot of times.
Yeah, so it's a form of epilepsy, but it's a very rare and catastrophic form. The children are born otherwise healthy, and then somewhere between the ages of 5 months and 9 months, they'll have their first seizure. It's usually prolonged, where it lasts about 25 minutes. Mm-hmm. And then from there on out, seizures set in. They can be prolonged seizures or daily seizures. But Dravet also affects body temperature. A lot of the children have speech issues, developmental delays. It affects every aspect of their lives.
And is there medication right now that can suppress it for a little while, or?
No, right now there's no cure for it. There's some medications that can help, but very, very few children are seizure-free. There's a medical diet. CBD's also been in the news, so there's hope out there, but there's been no cure found just yet.
And how do a lot of these families, you know, work through this process? It's tough. It's every day is a new challenge.
Yeah, and the way we live through it is day to day, and you just treasure every moment that you get with them, because there is a high risk of SUDEP with our children, mm-hmm. which is sudden unexplained death due to epilepsy. So you're just grateful for every day that you have with them and every second, because you never know when a seizure is going to happen. As I mentioned to you yesterday, we were playing in the pool here, and she had one.
Right.
And
you just deal.
You just deal, and thankfully the strangers at the pool helped me take care of her. And then instead of spending the day exploring beautiful Providence, right. we were stuck in the hotel room with her sleeping for a few hours.
Okay. And for you, do you talk to your friends about it? Do you tell them, you know, okay, this is what's going on. I have this Dravet syndrome. And do they even ask you questions?
Well, I don't actually know yet.
Yeah?
So I think they might, and I think they do talk to me about it.
About your seizures.
How about more importantly, what do you like to do?
Well,
do you like to watch TV? What do you watch on TV?
Well,
Let's get down to business.
I always watch Teenage Mutant Ninja.
Yeah, that seems to be the thing. Who's your favorite Teenage Mutant Ninja?
Well, I really love is Donatello.
Do that again. You have some cool moves. Do another move. There.
Okay.
Show us. Go ahead. Come on. Another Teenage Mutant. Ooh, sweet. Nice moves. Little love.
Thanks.
High five. Nice. Nice having you here today. I'm glad you came in. Glad you got the dress on and all TV ready, okay?
Okay,
good stuff. If you want to learn more about Dravet Syndrome Foundation and how to get involved, because the Rock and Roll Providence Half Marathon, they have stepped up by running or even volunteering, just head to the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com for more information. Give us another cool move. Come on, one more move. Go. Come on. Cool move. There you go.